What's up, everybody? This is Impactjunky coming at you via the Share feature on PlayStation 4. Just wanted to do a follow-up on my Interceptor unlock video, show you guys a little bit more action, pick back up where we left off. I was kind of hoping that that convoy of marauders that ran into us would stop to mix it up with Max, but I guess they were too scared to get out of their vehicles. They did, however, damage the Interceptor before taking off and running like punks. So I pulled the car back behind the service station and plan on searching it more thoroughly. Hopefully we'll be able to find what we need in way of scrap to repair the vehicle and be on our way in search of more fuel. Not to mention Max's canteen is getting pretty low. Looks like we found some scrap. No shortage of hubcaps in the wasteland. Looks like the sun's coming up. No place like home. This isn't a bad spot apart from the everything. Alrighty, water. I figure after this we're gonna go scrounge for some more fuel. I don't think we've got what we need in the tanks to keep up with a convoy and get our revenge. So we're just gonna get our kicks off of some other place. Take us out of video capture mode and see how much health Max is gaining from each drink. Looks like if we put him back up to full health, we'll have no water left, so we need to be a little conservative here. Repair the car with the scrap that we found by pressing square, not holding it. Pretty sure there's the small, or the remnants of a small town to be exact, up the road this way. If we can stay on the road, that is. A couple little details I forgot to mention about this car in the previous video. If you go into photo capture mode and look underneath it, there is no bomb or knife booby-trapped under the vehicle. Would have been neat to see that, but it's kind of unnecessary to go to that much detail in a game. I believe this is the place I was talking about. Alright guys, I had to make a little cut in the video so you wouldn't be bored to death by me trying to figure out how to get up here on the ledge without ruining the car. Now that we're up here, we can scope this place out a little bit, see what we're getting into. If this was an actual bad guy encampment instead of just a small location, we would be able to see a few little tags that we could mark with this set of binoculars here. Nevertheless, we've gotten a distant view of the place. We can go take a look up close. I would leave the car up here, but if you stray too far away from the Interceptor and any other vehicle that's not the Magnum Opus, the main story vehicle, then they kind of have a tendency to disappear, especially if you get into another vehicle. That's one thing that bothers me a little bit, so I try to keep the Interceptor either within sight or as close as possible all the time. I I see a little information marker up here. Looks like somebody that can maybe tell us something about this place before we rush headlong into it.
Is that you gotta put her to the test? Let me show you some spots where she can shine.
And then sit on a rock. I probably should have read that. I just saw the words Grippa token and went right on. Let's park the interceptor and then get to clearing this place out, because Max could use a little more water, fuel, and scrap. This looks like a good spot. Might not be totally out of sight, but at least it's not perfectly in the open. This place is mysteriously quiet. I was expecting it to be inhabited by bad guys, or marauders, or whatever you call them. Wow, super jump. This is probably where everybody's at. I can see this red banner. Dew collector. I forgot to mention that earlier in the video. These dew collectors are legitimate means of survival that they teach you about in the army and other places like that. My grandpa taught me about them long before I ever played this game. See what these guys had on them. Seems to always be scrap metal. Yeah. The other two guys' bodies have already disappeared. I kind of wish that the bodies of your foes and the vehicles that they drive would stick around a little bit longer after they get destroyed. Up the crankshaft with one rod and piston still attached to it, because that's totally useful after it's been sitting out there in the sand all this time. I know I heard one of you guys. Where you at? Nice if I could find a crowd of people that's worth shooting with a shotgun. Maybe it's not a crowd of people we're gonna have to find. Just one other doofus with a gun. Wow. He's really not that bright, is he? It's cool. There you have it, gun versus gun. And we've replaced the one shell. I like how you tend to find shells in pairs or triplets or just one single shell by itself in this game, as opposed to a whole box of them. Ammunition is scarce, along with water and gas. providing that you separate your Griffa tokens properly. As a lot of you will notice on this page, I haven't used any of my Griffa tokens on fuel consumption, and I've used hardly any of them on water essence. And doing that gives you a little bit more of a survival-like challenge. I would recommend that to anybody that's playing the game and looking for a bit of a hardcore mode, if you will. Also, if you're looking for a really crazy experience, you can turn on video capture mode, and it removes your HUD and your ammunition counter and pretty much everything else. That all entails the HUD, though. Oh, looky here. Some underground spot. Probably the basement of some store or something. I forgot to mention, in video capture mode, you don't see any combat prompts to dodge. That makes it a new challenge as well. You can still kick ass, though. You'll just take an extra hit every now and then. Make sure I'm not leaving anything behind in here. I'm glad I did. Alright, scrap crew. Nothing in this corner.
You! Come to me! And let me rip your face off!
Oh boy, there's a boss in here. I had no idea we were going to face something like this.
Rip the spine out of your thing!
Missed him.
Finally!
Ooh. Gotta be a little quicker on the draw, Matt. Gave him that one. It's coming down to the last bits.
Finish him.
I wish I could finish him with the gun. I was a little too eager with those shells. Oh, never mind. I do get to finish him with the gun. I don't want to stop this episode here. Man, that guy was a fight. He must have had some armor or something to be just taking those shotgun shells. I think it's odd how it tells you a location is 100% looted in this game when you know there's stuff left in it. door blocking the way here. That was a surprise right after the boss. Yeah, these guys don't play around. Door, explosion required. Fuel. I don't know what to think about that. The car really needs some gas, and they want me to blow the door up. Hopefully there'll be some more around here. I'm gonna check around first. Maybe even see if blowing that door is necessary. Nope. It looks like blowing that door is just a separate way to get in and out of here. I need the fuel worse than I need the convenience. Oh boy, water. Water and gas. There's more than enough for him too. That's awesome. Max is gonna replenish some health here. Back up to half. Almost full. All right, let's take our spoils and leave this horrid place. Now, if you're looking at this from a realistic standpoint, how's Max supposed to get down off of here with all this gas and his bad knee? I guess this'll have to do. I love how you can hear his knee brace squeak a little bit once in a while when he's carrying a gas can. Maybe it's just something rubbing against the can, but it reminds me of the Rogue Warrior either way. I'm gonna have to take a break here real quick and splice. Alright guys, sorry about all the cuts in this episode, but I'm back and ready to wrap it up for you. We're getting kinda close to the 15 minute mark here, and that's all you can do. I've put it in screenshot mode so you can see that we've got one last guy to deal with before the gas is ours, so let's go ahead and take care of him and be on our way. Still not quite a full tank. Well, this is going to be the start of a neat little video series I'm going to do here. I think I'm going to call it The Misadventures of Mad Max or something along those lines. I appreciate you guys watching my two-part Interceptor Unlock video. And first of all, before I leave, I'd like to thank Avalanche Studios and WB Games for finally making the Mad Max game that fans have been looking for. And before I leave you guys, I'm gonna leave you with a nice little treat. It's gonna be me hauling butt around in the Interceptor, so you can finally hear what the supercharger sounds like now that we've got about a half a tank of gas. Once again, appreciate you guys watching my video. Have a good one.